Linear equation. Solve for x. That's it. Oh, let's go. Okay, now we are looking for x. Oh, that's right. So I don't need a on my left-hand side, right? So, okay. So best way is scratching technique. Okay. So scratch, then minus a. That's it. That's what x is. Very simple. See? Now c minus a. That's it. Now, what about this one? Oh, we are looking for x. So, oh, scratch, then minus 2m. That's it. Okay, so minus 2m. That's it. Now, what about this one? That's it. Okay, minus a, scratch, then plus a. So now always the opposite sign, right? Okay, plus to minus, minus to plus, multiplication to division, division to multiplication. That's it. Now, so b plus a, I'm gonna write this one so better way. Okay, a plus b, that's right. Alphabetical order, we have to respect that. Okay, now divide by, that's right, scratch 3, then a, divide by a. That's what x is, right? Very simple. Okay, how about this? Then, oh, plus 2, minus 2 here. Okay, then, okay, so x is, okay, y minus 2, then parenthesis, then divide by, that's right, scratch this one, so 5. That's it. Okay, now what about this one? Okay, x right there, so scratch this one away, so plus 4n. That's it. Now, I'm gonna write 4n first, okay, so it looks better. Okay, plus 7. Okay, then divide by, scratch this one, 6. That's it. Ooh. So what about this one? So minus b, now plus b. That's it. Okay, so b plus c, then parenthesis, and divide by, scratch this one, a. That's it. That's what x is. Okay, what about this one? Oh, minus? Uh-oh. If we have a minus, I can exchange this one, okay? So 2x and d. Okay, now, actually, I just scratch this one, then plus 2x. Then I scratch this one, then I'm gonna move this one to my left-hand side, see? Okay, so minus d. That's why, okay, so x equals right here. I'm gonna write this one first, okay? So actually, 2x equals, then 3y minus d, right? Okay. So that's it. So now, oh, I scratch this one, then divide by 2. That's it. Whole thing, just like that. Now, what about this one? Okay, so scratch this one, then minus by. Okay, then m minus by, then whole thing over scratch a. That's it. So a, that's what x is. Okay, for this, oh, that's right. So you know what? I treat this one like a right-hand side. Okay, so I'm gonna move this one to my right-hand side. That's it. Okay, then, oh, that's right. P was times, now divide by P, right? Okay, so divide by P. That's it. So actually, then minus 1, right? I scratch this one, then minus 1 right there. So which is RT, okay, equals, okay, S over P minus 1. Okay, I scratched already. Okay, then minus 1 means actually P over P, right? Oh, that's it, P over P. Okay, just like this. Then I can put this one together, right? Oh, that's right. So S minus P over P, but I scratch R. Okay, then R goes right there. Okay, so final answer for T is, okay, so S minus P over P minus R, P times R, which is PR. That's it. Okay, now what about this one? Oh, that's right. So I treat this one like right-hand side. Okay, V, just like this one. Then, so H equals, okay, then V, then divide by, oh, scratch this one. So pi R squared. That's it. Oh, very simple. What about this one? Oh, that's right. So I move this one to my right-hand side. So in your mind, you can do, okay? So now, okay, so h equals, then this one was divided by 2, now times 2 right here, right? Okay, which is 2a. Okay, that's it. So 2a. Then scratch this one, divide by whole thing right there, a plus b. Divide by a plus b. That's it. Oh, good looking right there. Now, what about this one? Oh, that's right. So a, I just put a right there. Okay. Then, oh, divide by 2. So times 2 right there. Then, oh, that's right. So a plus b. Okay, on my left-hand side. Then right-hand side. Okay, so 2a. Then I scratch this one, so over h. Then I need b actually, so I don't need a. That's why I scratch this one, so minus a. That's it. Oh, that's good answer. But I can put this one together. Okay, so now, okay, h. Maybe I can put h right here, then h right there. Then oh, the same denominator. Okay, just like this one. That means 2a minus ah, then whole thing over h, or like this one. So h goes right there. Okay, so nice looking. Okay, what about this one? X is square root of 4. You know what? Okay, so a lot of people make mistake on this one. Okay, no negative answer for this one. Okay, square root means always positive only. Okay, positive only. Okay, positive. Okay, that's it. So that's why this one is only 2, not positive negative 2, only positive 2. Remember? Okay, now what about this one? That's different story. So if you take 2 as a square away, that means plus or minus, then square root. That's why this x is then positive or negative 2. That's it. Okay, how about this one? So t equals d over r. That means divide, right? Okay, if you have a division like this one, so you can exchange with the t and r. Okay, so just like this one, r equals, okay, d over t. That's it. See, I just exchange it. So that's division. Okay, especially right-hand side. Look at this one. Okay, 5c and x plus 7. I'm gonna exchange. Okay. That means, oh, the left-hand side is going to be x plus 7 quickly as possible. Just like that. Then the right-hand side, oh, that's right. So 3a minus 2 over 5c. See? Then you scratch this one, then minus 7. Minus 7 means actually you can put this one together if you want. Okay? So simplifying, right? Okay, 5c right there, then 5c right there. So 5 times 7 is 35c. Okay, that's why this one is 35c. Okay, so move it away. Now, A, the same denominator, so you can put this one together, right? Okay, final answer going to be what? That's right. So 3c, actually 3a, okay, then minus 35c, then minus 2 over whole thing over, okay, 5c. So you can do that way. Oh, fantastic. Okay, what about the last one right there? Oh, yes. Okay, so now, oh, if you have, okay, absolute value sign just like this one, then you can take it off just like this. Okay, take it off, but positive negative, right? Okay, that means, oh, now you move 5 minus 5 to the right-hand side, okay, which is 5, right? Okay, so 2x equals 7. Okay, 7 is positive negative. Then minus 5, you scratch, then oh, 5 right there. Okay, then divide by what? Oh, scratch this one, divide by 2. Okay, that's why, okay, 5 plus 7, which is 12, divided by 2, which is 6. That's one possible answer. Okay, then what about 5 minus 7? Negative 2 divided by 2, negative 1, right? Now, you know what? When you have answers, to make sure you check, okay? So 6, you just plug in right there, say 6. Okay, then 6 times 2 is 12, minus 5 is 7. Oh, absolute value 7 is 7. Yeah, you're right. Okay. What about negative 1? See, try negative 1 right there. See? So negative 1 times 2 is negative 2, negative 5, negative 7. Absolute value? That's right, 7. Oh, that's right. In this case, you can take both, right? Okay, 6 and negative 1. Now, oh, the left-hand side right there. Oh, the first thing. So you're gonna scratch this one. Also, actually, I'm gonna move this one to my right-hand side first. Okay, so the same thing. Now, divided by t, now times t, right there, 8t. Oh, wait a minute. Then I scratch this one, then plus what? V0, right? Okay, so that means V equals 8t, okay, plus, okay, then V0, which is the initial velocity. Okay, usually V equals V0 plus 8t. Oh, that's right. That's the next time, so you're going to see this one anyway somewhere. Okay, now, oh, this one, degree Fahrenheit. That's what we need, right? Okay, so now, first of all, I'm going to move this one to my right-hand side. Okay, so equals degree Celsius. Then, oh, this one divided by 9 times 9. Okay, so actually just like this one. Okay, I'm going to rewrite this one. So 5 over 9. Then, okay, degree Fahrenheit minus 32 equals then degree Celsius. Okay, now, okay, divided by 9 times 9. Okay, times 5 divided by 5. Then minus 32 plus 32. That's it. See? That's what Fahrenheit is. Okay, degree Fahrenheit equals 9/5. And degree Celsius plus 32. That's it.